Chancellor Samuel Kluksab, Sheikh Zulassab, distinguished elders, Councillor Zishtiak, Councillor Naim, brothers and sisters, Sister Yvonne Ridley, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
On all of you. I can't tell you how pleased I am to see you all here again under one roof, because that would be untrue. No. I'm really, really proud of every person and every person not here who made the journey of the people here possible. I'm very sorry for my lateness. Without my CB radio and police escort, I was unable to make it to Paul Green, Park Hill, in time. So please forgive me for that. As a matter of fact, I spent most of the day so far on the telephone across the Atlantic, a subject to which I shall return. But I want to do a little retrospective thinking and talking, as I know that you have been doing here today, as well as project where I think we need to go from here. But to those who are here as family members, who are here as fellow members of local communities of those who went on the convoy, for those of you who are here because you raised funds to fuel and fill the convoy, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, not just in my own name, but in the name of the literally hundreds of Palestinians who have written to me, telephoned me since we returned, to express, as a young woman photojournalist called Imad did when she wrote to me just a few days ago from Gaza. She said many things, but the most important of which was this. She said, "We have lived in Gaza through many dark days. But I," she said, "have never seen our people so happy for many years as they were when that convoy entered Gaza. We lifted the hearts and the spirits and the morale of a people under bombardment, under massacre, and under siege. And as I said to you that day in Gaza, every person on that convoy is a hero and a legend, and forever." So you will always be the people who went on that convoy. You will always be the person that your children can be proud of, who didn't just weep, though weeping is important, who didn't just march and protest, though marching and protesting is important, but who were ready to go to face all the difficulties, which I've no doubt you've been discussing here today. Jocularly, we can discuss them now that we're through it. But difficult, difficult times they were. You were the people who, in Gaza's words, got out of bed, got into your cars, and you drove, and you drove, and you drove all the way to Palestine. By the grace of God, we reached the holy ground and we kissed it. And that will be something that we will never forget, that they will never forget, and which your families and your communities can be proud of forever. And when, as Sheikh Zihir said, we are presented with these passports, and I'm discussing with them now in Gaza the modalities of that, when we get them, I personally will come round to every community. We'll hold an event like this, and I'll present those passports to you. And I believe they'll be, how shall I put this patriotically, just as precious to you as the British passport that you required to get through those borders. While I'm on the subject of passports and visas, And Pontus, you will have noticed that the right wing, pro-Bush, pro-war, pro-Israel, dead end, has been almost out of office. Government in Canada has decided that I'm a security risk. What does that mean? Do they think I'm going to try and take them hostage? Who would pay ransom for that rancid crew in power in Ottawa? That would be the most pointless hostage taking in history. Their own families would tell you to keep them. What do they think I'm going to do? They think I'm coming into Canada with a Kalashnikov or with a bomb? No, I'm coming in with my free voice and my free spirit to speak the truth to the Canadian people. And what's the reason? Apparently, all of us aided and abetted terrorism, taking ambulances to Gaza is an act, apparently, of terrorism. Taking wheelchairs to Palestine is an act, apparently, of terrorism. Taking nappies for babies who don't have them, blankets for families who are cold, medicine for patients who are sick, food for people who are starving is an act of terrorism. This Orwellian perversion of the word terrorism is the narrative that has to challenge. The Palestinians are the victims of terrorism. It's Israel who are the terrorists.
Well, I'm going on Monday to the United States of America. I haven't heard from them yet. But I'll be flying into Newark, New Jersey, God willing, on Monday. And I shall be speaking in, I think, 10 cities in the United States. All the tickets are already sold. All the media interviews are already booked. And it's called the Palestine Tour, because Palestine is the key. Palestine is the heart of the matter. In fact, it's the flaw at the heart of the West's entire policy towards the East. The non-Muslim world's attitude towards the Muslim world. And if they need to know that anywhere, they need to know it most of all in the United States of America. So I'm taking this case to them on Monday. But I am going to go to Niagara Falls, which is the border between the United States and Canada. And I am going to try to cross the border into Canada to fulfill the obligations that I have undertaken. I hope by then the Canadian government has backed down, or the courts in Canada have forced them to back down. But one way or another, I'll be at that border and I will be heard in Canada also. Yesterday, 4 more young Canadian soldiers were killed in Afghanistan and 8 seriously wounded. That's the real reason they're afraid of me in Canada, because most people in Canada have already concluded that this unjust and immoral war in Afghanistan is doomed, and they ought to get their soldiers out of there and back home to their families. But for those of you who saw Channel 4 News last night, and you can see it on YouTube if you missed it, or on the Channel 4 News website, will have seen that I was confronted for the first 6 minutes of the program, not by a spokesman for the Canadian government, no. Not by someone speaking with the authority of the Canadian state, no.